Again, it's always thanks for watching. Today the topic is sterilization and disinfection, part 2. Let's start. In this video, I will talk about sterilization methods. Actually, there are several types of chemicals used in the sterilization process, but I will talk about the most common. The first chemical used in sterilization, which is ethylene oxide, its chemical symbol is C2H4O. This substance is considered gaseous and highly toxic and has no color at all. It kills all kinds of microbes, including spore-forming bacteria. This gas disrupts the genetic material of bacteria and viruses. It is used to sterilize the heart, lung machines, and sutures. Glutaraldehyde, high concentration. It has the same efficacy as the formaldehyde. It is used against tubercle, bacilli, fungi, and viruses. It is less toxic, but care must be taken because it irritant to the eyes and skin than formaldehyde. It is effective at room temperature and even against endospores. The sterilization process in this way requires exposing the sterilized materials for several hours. Here I will talk about disinfection methods. Especially the chemical agents. Specifically, we will start with aldehyde. It is active against the amino group in the protein in the liquid state. He is bactericidal and sporicidal and eliminate viruses. It is used to sterilize the catheters and also for fumigating wards. Alcohol. Actually, there are several percentages of alcohol, and these percentages express to us the concentration of alcohol that is present in the water. For example, the 70% alcohol is recommended to sterilize hands from viruses and bacteria, because alcohol penetrates into the membranes of harmful cells and eliminates them. But the 80% and 90% are not recommended to use it, because it contains a higher concentration of alcohol and is similar to the process of frying. In other words, the DNA of bacteria or viruses is not eliminated. It is used as antiseptics, and it is used by denaturing bacterial proteins. There is no activity against the spores. Halogens. It is from the family of nonmetals. And examples are chlorine and iodine. It is prepared antiseptic and used for any routine procedures such as blood tests or before any surgery. Phenols. There are other substances similar to phenol, which are ditol and Lysol. It is used as disinfectant for surgical instruments. The effectiveness of phenol lies by destroying the cell membrane. The cell membrane is analyzed and the contents of the cell are scattered. There is an important information, which is that soup that kills germs contains 2% of hexachlorophene, which is used to sterilize hands, dyes. To sterilize wounds and skin, aniline and acridine. Dyes cannot completely eradicate bacteria, as they are considered bacteriostatic, that is, stopping the activity of bacteria for a certain period of time. These pigments are more effective against gram-positive bacteria because they interact more with acidic group in the cell. Proflavine, acriflavine, euflavine, and aminocrine, they are pigments that dilute the complex genetic material of bacteria. As I said a while ago, it kills the main source that maintains the genetic characteristics of the bacterial cell, which is the DNA. Oxidants. Oxidants break down the cell membrane by oxidizing it. Examples of strong oxidants are chlorine and oxygen are strong oxidizers. It kills the bacteria that cause waterborne disease, such as cholera. Hydrogen peroxide is bactericidal and is effective against viruses, bacteria, yeast, and spore-forming bacteria. It becomes effective when it produces hydroxyl free radicals, which attacks the basic contents of the cell, such as lipids, proteins, and DNA. They sterilize the room by peroxide vapors. Caution should be exercised when using this vapor because it is considered toxic and affects eyes and respiratory system. Heavy metals. Examples of it are these MgCl2 and AgNO3. And it is considered the most effective against microbes. It binds to protein and stops the activity of enzymes, thus eliminating microbes. Physical methods. Especially disinfection. The first method which I will talk about is boiling, and pasteurization. The naming process goes back to the inventor of this method. His name is Louis Pasteur. He discovered that the deterioration of microbes is due to a suitable temperature that is used to preserve materials such as wine making. The process helps to get rid of Acetobacter and Lactobacillus bacteria. It is used also to get rid of Brucella, Salmonella, and poliovirus. Later, this process was added to pasteurization of milk. The method of pasteurization is used for food safety. It is used in two ways. The first is holding process. It is heated to a temperature of 62 Celsius for 30 minutes and then cooled to 7 Celsius. The second method is flash process, heating at a temperature of 72 Celsius for 15 minutes and then a quick cooling to 4 Celsius. The boiling in water. This process eliminates most of pathogenic infection in less than 10 minutes. Spores and hepatitis B are not eliminated. Steam process. This method is used by double wall box. Spores need 26 hours to be eliminated in this way. Tyndallization method. This method is used by Tyndall. The moist heating is used at temperature of 100 degrees for 30 minutes for consecutive days, and then it is placed in an incubator at a temperature of 37 degrees. It is used to sterilize sugar media and gelatin. Inspiration process. Similar to the process tyndallization, but different in temperature. The appropriate temperature for this process is 35 degrees. It is used to sterilize egg or serum media, Lowenstein Jensen, and Loeffler's media. Ultraviolet radiation, non-ionizing. The electromagnetic rays is used, whose waves are longer than the visible light. Because of its length, it is absorbed as heat. Infrared radiation is used to sterilize the syringes and the catheters. This method is also used to sterilize enclosed areas such as entryways, operation theaters, and laboratories. I hope you have benefited from the information, and whoever has any comment, please write it at the bottom of the video on sterilization and disinfection, part 2, and I will answer all the questions. Thank you for following up. Have a good day.